and all that shit. Shalom. All praises to you. How about show me how it's shy? You going over there? All praises to you. How about show me how it's shy? We're going to give double honors to the apostles of Great Millstone. We out here, Columbus, Ohio. We finna just get it in. You know what I mean? We're going to just go through the Spirit, see what the Spirit brings out. Oh, that's a good topic. Are you watching the video too?
Yeah, I watch it when I can, but I ain't getting nobody's notification.
Oh, yeah. That was a good video. Yeah, but
I ain't seen it though. I just brought it up.
Yeah, you already know it.
We're going through the spiritual fire, which is being tried, affliction, shit like that. You're coming as gold. Two-thirds, they got to go through that.
I just got one question. Where was Jesus at? No, let me start off with this. What white man did you die for your skin? I got 3 nails in my ankles. I got hit by a car when I was 14 years old. If I could survive 3 nails, my Jesus couldn't.
Exactly. So that slave ship wasn't named after none in the Bible.
Who wrote that Bible? King James was gay.
No, he wasn't. Shakespeare worked on the Bible.
Yeah.
Because he was an expert.
He was
an Israelite. He was a so-called black man.
Really?
You didn't know that? So you got a lot to learn.
Abraham Lincoln was black. You ain't never seen that original. And how they used to pick on him and make black faces out of him and stuff like that. I ain't got nothing right. I got my business.
Isis did. She didn't marry Akhenaten. Was married to Nefertiti, his sister, right?
Okay, now what's the rest of them that was named?
King Tut. Wasn't King Tut known that he was deformed? Yeah, he was deformed. He had the club foot.
Who's the oldest known gay couple? In Egypt. Look it up. The oldest gay couple was found in Egypt.
Hold up. Egypt's top god is Osiris, who doesn't have a penis. Their top god is castrated. So what? That's some faggot shit, ain't it? Yeah. Ain't that faggot shit when you teach that your top god don't have a penis? That's faggot shit. Yeah, she gone. She's only good for one thing. We know what that is. Yeah, you ain't gonna do that.
She said that.
That's a rat.
She said she got 3 nails in her. Now how can somebody die on the cross? You dumb bitch. When you on the cross, you know you fucking suffocating.
Hey, but look, that's good though. You got But you know, when the Lord was on the cross, what did they say? The same thing. It's like, if you're the Son of God, bring yourself off that cross. And guess what happened? After he died, the earth quaked, the earth split in half, the veil rent, the zombies started coming out the graves, the dead rose from their graves and started walking around, and then it was like, oh shit. Like, go ahead.
They did a study to see how I feel to be down on the cross. You know, they ain't really putting no nails in nobody, but dude, you know, he was like hanging on the cross.
Yeah.
And that nigga couldn't even last for 15 minutes because he was fucking suffocating. Every time he had to talk or whatever, he had to like go up like that. So
yeah.
That's how he died on the cross. He was suffocating and shit. Plus, he got beat before he died on the cross.
They beat his ass before he died on the
cross. And she's talking shit. She's talking shit about the white man. But that's easy to do, right? Because the Roman soldiers was right there, and what did they say? They was the ones who put him on the cross and was talking shit to him. You know what I'm saying?
Okay, I'm just gonna start here. Matthew 26. No, I'm just too far now.
Hey, that's that Israel. She was one of them wicked Israelites that was there on that day. You know, she was there, that everything is reincarnation. You can see that spirit. And she was out there talking about, we have no king but Caesar.
Right. This is Matthew 27:11. I'm sorry, 11. Yehoshaphat stood before the governor. And the governor asked him, saying, art thou the king of the Jews? And Yehoshaphat said unto him, thou sayest. And when he was accused of the chief priests and elders, he answered nothing. Then Pilate, then said Pilate unto him, hearing thou not how many things they witnessed against thee? And he answered him to never a word, insomuch that the governor marveled greatly. Now at that feast, the governor was wont to release unto the people a prisoner whom they would, and they had then a noble prisoner called Barabbas.
Yeah, Barabbas was a thief and a liar. Because that's who most people give, in this world that we live in, most people give praises to thieves, robbers, adulterers. If you're a big piece of shit, you're going to have a lot of friends in this world right here. You know what I mean? You're going to be very popular. You know what I'm saying? Go ahead.
Like old girl.
Yeah.
You know, she don't know the difference. A righteous man to a, she don't know the difference from a clean from unclean. She don't know the difference.
She don't know, yeah, right.
Therefore, when they were gathered together, Pilate said unto them, whom will ye that I release unto you? The robbers or Yehoshaphat, which is called Barashiah? For he knew that for envy they had delivered him.
Because Barabbas was probably in that Egypt shit too. You know what I'm saying? He was probably believing some whacked out shit. That's why he was a thief and a murderer.
When he was set down on the judgment seat, his wife sent unto him, saying, have thou nothing to do with that just man? For I have suffered many things this day in a dream because of him. But the chief priests and elders persuaded the multitude that they should ask Barabbas to destroy Yehoshaphat. The governor answered and said unto them, whether of the twain will he that I release unto you? They said, Barabbas, the nigga. Pilate said unto them, what shall I do then with Yehoshaphat, which is called the Mashiach? And they all say unto him, let him be crucified. And the governor said, why? What evil hath he done? But they cried out the more, saying, let him be crucified. When Pilate saw that he would prevail nothing, but that rather a tumult was made, he took water and washed his hands before the multitude, saying, I am innocent of the blood of this just
right
person.
Because the Lord is just, and that's why you see our people, that they'll embrace somebody who's wicked and evil before they embrace us. They're going to go kick it with some people who's engaged in a number of foolishness before they come kick it with us. That's why that's why our group is little. And the group of the unjust is big. You know, they got giant gangs.
Multitudes.
They got multitudes. That's why the scriptures say don't follow a multitude to do evil. You know what I'm saying?
Right. And who is this? This is the devil that washed his hands. He said this man is innocent, man. A devil?
Yeah, even the devil himself knew that he didn't do nothing wrong.
Right.
That's because Israel sins and surpassed the... Israel's
Jeremiah.
Wickedness surpassed the wickedness of the heathen. The only reason Pontius Pilate went through with it is because if they didn't, he'd have a riot on his hands.
Yeah, they said a tumult.
Yeah, a tumult. That's a riot. They were spitting a riot if they didn't put the Lord to death. So Pontius Pilate had to do it. Hey, Eddie, you still see that today, don't you?
Same shit.
That's why Esau just let him go.
Okay, see ye to it. Then answer all the people and say, his blood be on us and on our children. And that's what the Lord holds him to. He's holding him to. You know, this is spiritual demons. They didn't know that they're coming back in reincarnation. You know, they're going to have to get their ass children.
Saying the same, they saying the same bullshit now they said back then.
Same shit. Then release him, Barabbas, unto them, and when he had them to be crucified, then the soldiers of the governor took Yahushua into the commandant.
And that's another thing too, going because he's talking about the Egypt stuff. Because actually, the cross itself go back to Egypt. That's some Egyptian shit. Yeah, they go back to the Ankh and all that. That's not even a symbol. That's not even no biblical symbol. You see Christians using the cross, they in error when they do that.
The Lord kicked that motherfucker's cross down last week, remember?
Oh, broke, yeah, he said, fuck your cross.
That last week was spiritual for him.
Yeah, that was spiritual.
That was some other shit.
I was almost saying, was you do that?
That's like, wow.
I almost thought we got visited by an angel or something. I didn't know what was going on.
That dude literally got his ass whipped out there. Shit.
The Lord vexed the hell out of his
God. Got it good. Man.
You ain't gonna see him come back out.
Right. He changed his whole game. Like, he went to.
He called the cops.
He probably only go to work into the Western.
Oh yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
But they ain't gonna take his books up there. Only Jake gonna take.
Right. They don't care about
that. Yeah, you go to Esau. Ain't gonna take no bullshit Bible book.
Damn,
Jake can eat that shit up though. Probably some ancient witchcraft.
The devil be happy to tell you about that shit.
Oh, yeah. You know the whole story.
Right. Okay, then the soldiers of the governor took Yahushua into the common hall and gathered unto him the whole band of soldiers. And they stripped him and put on him a scarlet robe. And when they had plaited a crown of thorns, they put it upon his head and a ring in his right hand. They bowed the knee before him, mocked him, saying, "Hail, King of the Jews."
Right, that's what the white man did to the Lord, right? Because even though it's Israel's fault that he got crucified, but the devil, the Romans too, but they was tormenting too. They scourged him with a whip. They put a crown on his head, mocked him, laughed at him. You know what I'm saying?
Hold on a second.
You know them Roman, them Roman soldiers weren't no joke. You know they some battle hardened, some rough motherfuckers, man. They're some bad dudes. You know they was beating the shit out of the Lord before he even made it to the cross.
That was an ancient world.
Yeah, it was an ancient world. Now everything's all soft. You raised up, and even the average poor person got luxuries. You got heat. You got heat in the AC in your house and shit.
That's some shit.
You think they had AC back in the ancient Roman times?
Yeah.
Man, these motherfuckers was living rough. They was not in the house all day watching TV. They was outside. You know what I'm saying? Out there battling. Life was rough back in them days. Y'all got it easy now, man.
Okay, they spit upon him.
Spit nice. She a girl would have spit on him too.
And took the reed and smote him on the head. And after that, they had mocked him. They took the robe off from him, put his own raiment on him, and led him away to be crucified. And as they came out, they found a man of Cyrene, Simon the name by name. Him they compelled to bear his cross. When they were come unto a place called Golgotha.
I mean, she'd be cute if she took all that bullshit out of her hair and started acting right, you know what I mean? But yeah. You know that ain't gonna happen.
When you knock her ass out, she'd be cute laying there knocking
out. You look like, look at her sleeping. Yeah. So, she's so
adorable. Right. Yeah. She say, place of sport. A place of sport. They gave him vinegar to drink mingled with gall. And when he had tasted thereof, he would not drink. That's some foul shit, man.
Yeah,
that's shit. Gall is shit.
Yeah.
That's another word for bile. You know, crucify him and parted his garments, casting lots that it might be.
Yeah. Satan, boy, he didn't like that scripture.
No, they don't like that. Same thing was going on when he was being crucified. That earthquake.
There was an earthquake and all that. Yeah.
I forgot to put my weight
on. My shit's broke. If I hang anything from it, it'd just break off. Oh shit, my fault.
It'll be alright.
That was just a little gust. It'll be alright. Actually, my mind works.
Certainly no joke.
Might work.
I remember one of the windstorms. This is off topic, though. I got it right here.
Yeah.
The last windstorm we had, I was out in it, right? And the wind was blowing. You see the trees damn near looking like they're about to
top
over.
Yeah, they about to snap.
And went no wind touching me. I was out in it. I was like, I was in awe. Like, damn, why no wind touching me? I was tripping.
That's how it be when a tornado goes through a neighborhood. You see every house destroyed, but every that one house left.
Right.
It was probably, you know, probably a righteous man living up in that house. The Lord's crazy like that. Hey, I was just reading. That's the spirit. I was just watching this video last night on how Spain, y'all know the history of Spain battling with England with their ships and their armadas. But Spain kept trying to invade England over and over again with their ships. Spain had the mightiest navy in history, right? But every time they tried to invade England, they got hit with a storm and fucked all their ships up. So you want to, that was the Most High intervening because England had to be the dominant power in the world. You know, that's just how the shit had to go down. But the Lord intervened.
With Alexander the Great.
Yep, Alexander the Great. He didn't do that by himself.
Right. They have reports. It's actually in the books that Alexander sold chariots.
It is a chariot, yeah.
Christopher Columbus, too.
Christopher Columbus. Constantine the Great.
Yeah.
Constantine the Great seen the sign in the sky, in the heaven.
Wow.
You remember?
Sure, yeah.
Yeah. They said, by that sign, you conquered.
Not that we ain't saying that the Lord was with them like that.
No,
but prophecies had to take
place. The scriptures say that the heart of the king is in the hands of the Lord. So actually, I mean, the Lord ain't with the wicked, like, but that's his instrument, you know what I'm saying?
His instrument of weapons.
Yeah, that's it, the Lord's instrument. It's like Donald Trump, the Lord gave him that power.
I'm not saying white man, where does it say that? Okay, back to Matthew.
The scriptures say you should know them by their fruits.
And sitting down, they washed him there and set up over his head his accusation written, "This is Yahushua, the king of the Jews." Then were there two thieves crucified with him, one on the right hand and another on the left.
Oh yeah, here you go. Check this out.
And they that passed by reviled him, wagging their heads, and saying, "Thou that destroyest the temple and buildest it in 3 days, save thyself."
See, they're so stupid, they didn't, you know what I mean? They didn't understand. He was talking about himself. You know what I mean? Because he had prophesied that even though this temple is going to be destroyed, it's going to rise after 3 days. He was talking about himself. He was going to rise from the grave, right? So he got Israelites talking shit, talking about, why can't you save yourself from that cross? That's the same thing your girl said. If she claims she know the Bible inside and out, she didn't know that scripture. You know what I'm saying? Because you feel like a piece of shit after saying something like that, man. That's only something a piece of shit would say.
Yeah, a piece of shit, man. Right.
What do you think the point of crucifixion is? You're
going
to die. Right. And I'm going to get angry. Just come back down.
And he was obviously a righteous man. What was the Lord teaching? He wasn't teaching people to be wicked. He was teaching you to love your brother, love the Most High. So you going to talk shit like that to somebody that's on the cross?
You know what I mean?
You know what I mean? Didn't do nothing wrong, and you going to talk that kind of shit?
Real, he even did the devil a favor. The devil got his ear chopped off.
He put it back on.
Right, like, what? Damn. Freaking motherfucker out.
That's what freaked Peter, because Peter was in that raw spirit. He wanted to kill him. Right. He chopped his damn ear off.
So we're a bunch of Peters.
Yeah, we might. We ain't got the spirit of the Lord. Well, we try to have the spirit of the Lord, but the Lord was all perfection. We ain't perfect like the Lord is perfect. Like you said before, who you talking about? Oh, them. But like you said, what I meant though is like, how many of you, if we came out here and somebody came up, spit on us, punched us, what somebody swung on?
Woo!
Most people's gonna swing back and start fighting. You know what I mean? That's just instinct. But the Lord, he didn't even fight back.
I ain't trying to fight nobody's hero, but goddamn, these niggas are trying to want to do that shit. For real, man.
That tells you the Lord had a special, you know, the Lord.
He's special.
He's special, man.
It's a heavy spirit.
Right.
What did Elisha say to Elijah before departing? Those of your heavy spirits, something like that.
Oh, yeah, he said, give me some of your, pretty much your vibration or something.
So must be.
Yeah.
Fire.
Yeah, he was on fire.
Heavy spirit.
Hey, the Lord loved Elijah so much, he beamed him up and took him to the heavens.
Up,
he got beamed up.
Right, right. What we yearn for.
He didn't even die. He got beamed up.
Ain't that something, man?
You be praying, I get beamed up.
I get abducted.
Man.
You see you on Channel 10 News here, Columbus. Radical speaker out there on High Street gets beamed up. Prophet of anger gets beamed up.
Oh, nah, bro. They going to be on the news.
Right,
you
right.
Have to,
right.
They'll be on coast to coast. You know what I'm saying?
Coast to coast AM.
Yeah.
Right.
They going to have, it'll be on the news for like one day. Oh, and then they going to censor it and delete the video. You know how they do it.
They going to be like that movie Fire in the Sky. Y'all seen that movie?
Oh, that's a badass movie. Yeah. That's a good one.
About 92.
Yeah, that was the best one.
Yeah, that was a good one. Dude got abducted, but they found him on the other side of town, butt naked.
Yeah, butt naked.
The alien stripping and shit. What the fuck? Right.
Yeah, my shit is real.
That's crazy, man. Now the aliens are homos. That's Esau's mind, man, writing that shit that the alien stripping motherfuckers. Anal probing of the shit.
Because I heard the people that did get left butt naked after they got abducted, that was done by the government. That's only the government with anal probing.
That's funny though, because the angels do be abducting and beating my speak their ass. They really do beat their ass.
Oh, yeah. That's just a piece of shit.
So butt naked, man. Humiliating. That's what the angels is doing. They humiliating them motherfuckers.
They don't believe nothing.
Yeah, man. Do that now. Butt plug, you know? Butt plug. Back to Matthew 27 and all. And saying, thou that destroyest the temple and buildest it in 3 days, save thyself, if thou be the Son of the Most High, come down from the cross. Likewise, also the chief priest.
That's just evil. I can't just believe your girl actually said that shit.
I didn't see that coming.
Yeah, she actually said that. She's like, why can't she don't take the nails out of that? That's some fucking evil shit to say.
Go ahead yourself.
I got something great and special for her too. And I can't, I hope I see it. Yeah, I hope I see it.
All right, they incorporate it. I didn't think about that.
White niggas.
Put on a guillotine. Guillotine? Yeah. So guillotines is here now. They got guillotines. They got actual guillotines, man.
But Esau ain't gonna have much use for it.
That's crazy, man. Guillotines.
I know. Government ordered a bunch of them.
Yeah.
He took one out for it. He didn't use the Esau.
Oh, right. You see her titties?
Yeah.
You see the top hood? That's from all them built portions.
That's
prophesied
with this
stabbing
in the head like that.
That's the bitch.
Big no edge having.
Oh,
nobody
know
edge.
Stabbing in the head. Yeah, that's right. You stab.
That's why she had rope for hair. Like rope and yarn. Who the hell? Who in that right mind gonna put that in her hair?
And she gonna say the Lord can't save himself because she can't grow her own hair.
Right. Gotcha. Yeah. Gotcha.
Oh, you know what? Before I get into you, come back.
That's a good one. Oh, yeah. She's talking about the Bible bullshit that she's going to say she's there. She's a guy.
I told you that wind is going to come, man.
They just
put
them signs up.
Shit. I told you. Say you get this, man.
Especially.
I knew it was gonna come. Just getting so we can see an example. Just to see that example, man.
Let me see it. Just put these up for a minute.
This is, you know, that's crazy.
We can
man.
Stand on them.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to stand on them. That's bad. That's bad. That's bad. Went through the way. Well, this is Limbada Cup. We're gonna stand on them anyway. We're gonna be stepping on them.